members of the Minneapolis City Council have announced their intentions to dismantle their police department. Now, to some people, it might sound like a radical idea, but it won't be the first city in the country to do it. The city of Camden, New Jersey, did it in 2012. Joining us now is Louis Capelli, Jr., freeholder, director, and county executive of Camden County, New Jersey. Sir, thanks so much for being with us. In 2012, Camden disbanded its police department, dissolved it. Why?
We dissolved it because there was a fiscal crisis and there was a public safety crisis. The recession destroyed the finances of the state of New Jersey and the city of Camden. At the same time, we had a crime rate that was ranked number one in the nation. We had 67 murders in 2012, so a change was needed.
And just so people know, when we say you dissolve the police department, people are saying, oh, if you dismantle or defund police, it's going to mean anarchy. It's going to mean there's no law enforcement. The next day, did people wake up and were there no law enforcement or public safety officers on the street?
Not the case at all. For 2 years, we worked together with Governor Christie, our Senate President Steve Sweeney, our Senator Donald Cross, and our Mayor Dana Redd to come up with a plan to develop a county police department that took the place of the city police department. And we were told all along, this will never work, it'll never happen, the unions will fight you. But with the support from the governor on down, we were able to accomplish the absolute dissolution of the city department, which was not doing its job, which was failing miserably, and replace it with a county department that was focused on community policing.
And I do know that about 100 of the officers who were part of the city department became part of the county police force of about 400 people. So there was some overlap there. And you were talking about the homicide rate in 2012, just so people can see the change over the last 7 or 8 years. It's a 62% decline in the homicide rate in Camden, New Jersey, since this change was made. That's a positive move. Now, it all looks good and sounds good when you put that number up on the screen, but we should note that Minneapolis is 4 times, 5 times the size of Camden, New Jersey. What are the risks?
Right.
What does Minneapolis need to know about the challenges of doing this?
Listen, the challenges will come because change never comes easy. But if your philosophy in community policing is to engage the residents of your city in the development of a new force or the reform of a new force, and you put that philosophy into practice, whereby the residents give you input on how you police, what kind of officers you hire, and you start building that trust with your residents, and you have a relationship with your residents, you will see crime drop. A big part of why crime has dropped so drastically in Camden City is the fact that our residents are now our partners. They trust our police. They see our police as guardians, not as warriors. Our police officers have pop block parties. They go into the schools to read the school children. And each day, when there's a new officer hitting the street, he goes door to door in the neighborhood he is serving, hands out his card to residents and says, call me. If you need anything, give me a call. Don't just call me in times of trouble. So we're getting a lot of information from our residents, working out very well. There's still challenges, but meet those challenges.
Can that be done? Or why is it easier, should I say, or why is it different to do that building from the ground up by dissolving and rebuilding from scratch than it would be just to say to a department, we're going to implement these changes? We're going to say you have to go knock on doors and introduce yourself.
Well, for us, it was easier because the rules and regulations of the city department and the contracts were unsustainable. They were too expensive. Our superior officers had very little discretion on how to even deploy officers. So at any given time, the most, the highest number of police officers on the street in Camden City were like 8 to 12 officers, which simply was a horrific situation and led to a high crime rate. So by wiping the slate clean, we were able to start with new union contracts, new rules and regulations, and we took all the savings that we were able to garner and put them into hiring more officers. So we have tripled the number of officers on the street, really walking and biking the street every day.
Now, one thing I do want to note is that the statistics I've seen, it hasn't led to a more diverse police force in Camden County at this point, has it?
Well, yeah, it is a bit more diverse. We have about 52% minorities make up our force. That number would be higher, but the current New Jersey civil service rules and regulations prevent us from getting to the numbers we want to have. They employ these tests to hire police officers, to promote officers. And those tests, frankly, are racially biased, outdated, and really need to go away or be modified significantly. So we are doing our absolute best to make the force as diverse as possible.
As people hear the debate about dismantling or defunding police forces around the country, what do they need to know? Because it really does. When you say the sentence, people go, huh? Are you serious? That sounds scary. But what do people need to know?
People need to know, first of all, we did not defund. We're actually investing more in our police department. We're doing it smartly. We're investing in technology and in training. De-escalation training, community policing training, that's where funds need to be invested. So listen, it's not one model fits all. You have to customize this model to your situation and facts. But if you start with the premise that people want to be treated with respect and people want to have input into their law enforcement service that's provided to them, I think you'll do well.
All right, Louis Capelli, great discussion. Thanks so much for being with us. It provides much more context into some of the discussions going on around the country.
Thank you.